But next, we're delighted to welcome Steve. Now, Steve is a Nigerian advertising and music executive, a public advocate, the founder of X3M Ideas, which is a Lagos-based digital advertising agency. This agency was listed fastest growing communication agencies. And as I mentioned earlier, Steve is also the president of the Association of Advertising Agencies of Nigeria, a very busy man, I think you would all agree. But yes, Steve is joining us today for a very special welcome and hello. So hello to Steve, and I'm going to hand over to you.
Thank you so much, Aisling. Thank you so much for the opportunity, and a big shout out to the UK House at Nigeria for putting all of this together. Shout out to Chim and Ben also for the short remarks that they made, that they just gave us. So I'd like to officially say welcome to Nigeria to everybody that's not in Nigeria joining us today. This is one of the best countries in the world, I say so myself. Nigeria, as we know, I'm not going to bore you with all of the statistics that are out there, but clearly seventh most populous nation in the world with over 200 million people, you know, and definitely the most populous black nation on God's own earth. So it's a beautiful place to be. And as far as advertising goes, it's all about the population and how it's growing. We all know that mostly the American market and the European market are near saturation point. I think this is the next frontier for any form of advertising and trade into the future. It's a pretty young population, probably one of the most youngest population in the world. And with the median age of about 18 years old, so you can see that the future is actually quite bright. So, I mean, I'm saying all of this for people who are joining us today who might be interested in this market. It's not just about being interested in this market for today. It's about what the future actually holds for this market. It's according to all of the UN statistics, by 2040, 2050, it's projected that Nigeria will be about maybe over 400 million people. By that time, it will be about the third most populated country in the world behind just China and India. So, I mean, the opportunities are quite huge. I mean, the history of also advertising in Nigeria goes back to almost a century, but I think it was in 1973 that some of the founding fathers of the industry in Nigeria came together and they formed what was then known as the Advertising Practitioners, Association of Advertising Practitioners of Nigeria, AAPN, which today is known as AAAN, Association of Advertising Agencies of Nigeria, which I'm now president. So it means that in another few years, in 2 years, we'll be 50 years old as an association, and the association has the responsibility of managing all of the industry issues as far as it goes with legislation, working with APCON, which is our regulator, working with the government to wrap up a whole lot of stuff. And today, AAAN has about 90 members because this association is only registers advertising agencies and not individual practitioners. So we have about 90 members. And between these 90 members, we hire like hundreds and hundreds of practitioners, you know. And like Ben rightly said, and Chim also, that the size of our industry is almost $500 million, which is roughly about maybe slightly over 1% or maybe just about 1% of the GDP, which is about over 400 billion. So I think if you look at that ratio, you say that the South Africans are outperforming Nigeria significantly because the South African market is about almost 3 billion of a GDP that's just slightly over $300 billion, you know. So it's about six times the size of the Nigerian market. And again, it's not so good news, but it's also good news for people who may be interested in this market, because it shows that the ceiling is still very high for us to be able to grow and grow advertising business in Nigeria. Well, I became president about a year ago, so I'm just about a year into my presidency, and I'm really, really happy to be working with a whole crop of new minded exco on my team, who some of them you'll be hearing from them, people like Mr. Larry Adisa, who will be speaking today, and my Vice President Jenkins Salumano, and all the other wonderful ladies that are also on our ESCO, talked by Jemma Ligbe and Mrs. A. All of them have really, really supported us in pushing the new agenda that we've been pushing over the past 1 year. And I'll just run you through some of the big ticket items we've been working on since I became president. One of the immediate ones that holds a very special place in my heart is closing the gender gap in our industry, because we realize that as you go through your career in advertising in Nigeria, I don't know if this is peculiar to Nigeria alone, we see that women sort of drop off from the lower management cadre. Once you start to get into the senior management, you don't see too many women. And we wanted to see that we close that gender gap. And just as a starting point, we hired the first director of the AAAN, who is the first woman to run that position in over 50 years of the association. We're very excited about that. And we're working with also APCON to raise equity participation of foreign interest in advertising. Today, it stands at no foreign participants allowed to own more than 25% equity. We want to raise that significantly. I was at the National Assembly just a few months ago, still working on the new laws. And I'll just say, there's so much opportunity here, man. Welcome, the Nigerian advertising industry is open for business. I would use this opportunity to welcome people who might be interested. I also like to say shout out to Mark Reed of WPP and his team. He has significant plans based on some of the conversation I've had with him. I think the Omnicom group are here, Publicis are here as well. So, I mean, all of the UK advertising conglomerates who might be interested in Nigeria, this is a place to do business. Thank you so much, Ashlyn, for the opportunity. And I look forward to further engaging on this topic and welcoming you to Nigeria. Thank you.